Our first guest tonight is an Emmy-nominated actress and director. You know best from her work on Cocaine Bear, Pitch Perfect, and the Hunger Games films. Her newest film, Migration, is in theaters everywhere on December 22nd. Please welcome back to the show, Elizabeth Banks, everybody! How are you?
Yeah, Brian!
Brian knows what he's doing.
Brian, thanks
there.
For that.
This is very exciting. Hi. You've been on the show, but remotely only.
So that's right.
First time in the studio.
Yeah, I got to stay at home in my pajama bottoms last time I was here.
Would you? I mean, you must have done a lot of talk shows during the COVID time. Was it always pajama bottoms?
Usually. Yeah. I mean,
it wasn't the worst time to be on a talk show.
It was a lot easier. Yes. I just had to keep the dog quiet.
Yep.
That's always tough.
Yep.
And the kids quiet. That's it, you know?
That's maybe
like
even a little tougher.
Like nobody coming in to like ask mom for something.
Well, it's a very small period of time, but of course kids will still find
Course. Are you kidding me? It's Murphy's Law.
Do you have them with you now on this holiday time in the city?
I just had them. We came for Thanksgiving for the first time with the kids. It was actually the first time I ever had Thanksgiving in a restaurant, too.
Wow.
I didn't know that was a thing.
It's pretty amazing.
Guys, that's like... I figured it out. Let me tell you.
When you leave and like other people do the dishes,
you don't do anything.
There's no
cooking and cleaning up.
Also, I'll tell you this: families, you know where they behave better? In a restaurant.
They sure do.
Yeah.
And they dressed up.
Yeah.
Because it was like felt like an event. You know.
Yeah.
Versus me being like, can you put on something nice for the photo?
Did the kids appreciate a restaurant? Were they excited about that?
They were, actually.
That's great.
They liked it, too.
How many of you were there, was
just
it?
Just the four of us.
Oh, that's a dream. I mean, now you could have won anyway,
though. I know, by the way. We did a lot of family time earlier in the year, and my son is actually, he's going to be bar mitzvahed.
All right.
In the new year.
Very exciting.
Thank you.
So you then...
He's becoming a man.
He's becoming a man right in front of our own eyes.
That's it. And so we're going to have a lot of family time, and we do a lot of family at the holidays. So we spend our Christmas in our house in Utah, and we have my husband's whole family come. So
that's great.
We got to sort of have just the four of us for the week here in New York.
That's great. You have Hanukkah starting on Friday.
Yes. Thursday night, first night.
Thursday
right?
night, maybe. Yeah. You're right. We always like to make our kids. We like to make our kids wait a day.
I see.
Really? You have not been great this year. You're getting 7.
I like that.
Yeah, we went over the numbers. You're getting 7 this year. But I don't know, my kids are a little younger, and so they are very, they love the fact that they have this multiple.
Yeah.
Are your kids, have they outgrown that, or are they still super psyched about Hanukkah?
You know, they've outgrown it a little bit in that they want like one big present.
Because
that's kind of what we do, and then we do like little things along the week. And, you know, the other thing the other tradition that we like is we make them pick a charity to give to this time of year. I think it's really important to give back as well. And so letting the kids kind of be part of that process has been fun over the years.
That is very nice.
Yeah.
And I think it's obviously what ultimately these holidays are supposed to be about. You saw maybe the best celebrity sighting when you were
I really did.
And this is so cool because you're walking over the Brooklyn Bridge and it's maybe the last place you expect to see a celebrity. And I kind of noticed you got a picture of them without them noticing maybe that you even saw them.
Yes. Well, then when they did notice, that's this whole story.
But,
so this is the Grinch.
Yep.
And he was fully on the Brooklyn Bridge. And you see, he was Grinching out.
Yeah.
He was like, get the F off this bridge.
Yeah.
Like, he couldn't believe how many god darn people were on the bridge.
Yeah.
Over Thanksgiving. And when he saw that we were taking a photo, which saw on my husband's camera, sorry guys, sorry, late night. He went like this. Like he was so done.
Yeah.
I was like, what an amazing character.
It's
this guy
so
got
fun.
Up in the morning.
Yeah.
He put on this outfit, guys. He did the full makeup face. I mean, he looked like he was right out of the movie. This was not some like jokey, furry version for kids. This guy was in character.
It's so fun, too, because I do will say, like, Thanksgiving Grinch is one who's just, like, already tired.
So over it already.
Yeah, like,
it's not
here
even
we
December.
Go. Yeah.
And he's like, oh, this. Yeah.
We did our Christmas card this year was our daughter was Cindy Lou. Who is it, Cindy?
Yes. Yeah, Cindy.
And then a middle Axel was Max the dog.
Oh,
and then Ash wanted to be a Max the dog, our oldest.
Sure.
And we were like, the suit doesn't fit. You have to be the. And so he was in a really bad mood that he had to be the Grinch. And then we're taking the pictures, and I'm like, you have to smile. And he was like, I'm being the Grinch. And I was like, oh, I'm sorry. Because I thought he was just mad about being the Grinch. But no, he's like, no, I've accepted I'm the Grinch now. And now, I'm just in character.
That's right. He went deep. Good for him.
Do you have any holiday traditions that your kids have now?
We go skiing.
That's
so
not
because
bad.
We're Jewish, we get to get up on Christmas morning.
Yeah.
And go, like, first tracks, you know?
Yeah.
Like, no one's there. They're all opening presents.
Yeah.
And we are just, like, we're having breakfast on the mountain, and we get, this is fantastic.
Do you have are your boys adventurous skiers?
Very.
Yeah.
To the point where I'm about, maybe this will be my last season where I can really keep up.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I think I'm about to be bounced out of the whole crew.
I guess if they've been doing it long enough, you don't live in fear. Are they good?
I used to not be able to go at all. Like, I spent the entire time, my anxiety level was like at a 15 out of 10. Like, they were gonna just fly off the side or into the trees, and then they would go in the trees and like ski in the trees, and I was like, come back, you know? And like, I still make them wear a whistle.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so that when they get stuck in a well, they can like whistle their way out. I don't know. Guys, I'm nervous.
That's so funny.
And now they have, you know, the watch, so they can be like, come get me, I'm half dead. You know, that's what you worry about, basically.
I like but the I very high-tech of a watch and the very low-tech of a whistle.
Yeah. Yes.
You've really covered, like, basically 200 years of parental safety.
Exactly right.
Yeah, they wear a bell.
Can't be too safe, you know?
All right, well, that's good. I also want to talk about your film, Migration. We're going to have more with Elizabeth right after this.